Hi, and welcome to the new edition of KnightZone. I'm your permanent host, Mike Gaynor.
And I'm your other permanent host, Lee O'Dea.
KnightZone's going to start coming to you every other week. We're going to make sure everyone gets their fulfillment of Oak Creek Sports Entertainment. But to start the show off right, I'm going to have to say we're going to have to recap of all the sports that just got done so the new sports can move on in.
Sounds good.
Who was the wrestler who broke the school record for most wins and just recently went to state? Here's Ryan Casper with the answer.
I'm Ryan Casper, and this past season, Drake Horn has beaten the record with 118 wins. That's most in school history. Sorry. Now here's an exclusive interview with him.
How do you feel about breaking the record?
It feels good.
Stocks are max.
No big deal.
Those people were out there.
It's cool just to know that you got the record now here, so that's cool that way.
Was it hard breaking the record?
Well, I guess. If you think about it, I was on varsity since freshman year, so if you win about 30 matches a year, so... Not really.
Was it ever a goal when you were a freshman to, break the record?
No, not at all. No.
Was it a goal at the beginning of the year? Of the season?
Yeah, this year, yeah. This year.
We also did an interview with Coach Hauerwas.
How do you feel about Drake's record of breaking it?
I'm pretty proud of it, actually. I think it's... it's one of those kind of marks that's a landmark and it's a benchmark and it's been there for a long time. When Aaron said it, you never know if somebody's going to come along that's going to beat it because it is it's a pretty prestigious record to have that those amount of wins. And all of a sudden you started looking at him last year and thinking, well, he's got a shot. And then of course you get closer and you think, well, don't get hurt, no injuries, stuff like that. I was really excited when he broke it. I think he's gonna smash that record. It's not even gonna be close, and I think I will probably be long gone, and that record will still be here. I think it's gonna take somebody real special to come into this building and beat it. I mean, when you look at 118 wins as of today, that's almost 30 a year for 4 years, and that's pretty impressive. And he's not done, so I would think by the end of the season, if he has the kind of year that he's having, I would say he's gonna be finished with between 130 and 140 wins, which is going to be real tough for anybody to catch. So,
do you think he'll get a scholarship for wrestling?
He's capable. Scholarships in wrestling are real, real rare because there's just not a lot of money, and colleges and stuff don't have that kind of money to throw around. So, to get college scholarships, I think it's real difficult. I think he's got a real good chance at a place like Parkside. Which is really a very high quality Division II school, and they have an outstanding program. They're probably second only to Wisconsin as far as their caliber of wrestling and the kind of athletes they get there. They get a lot of state champs, they get a lot of state place winners, and I know he's interested in going there, and the coach has given me a call and is interested in him coming as well. So I think he's got a real good chance of going there and probably being real competitive and doing a good job.
When you first saw Drake, did you think he'd be this overpowering?
No. He'll see this on TV. I always knew he'd be a good wrestler simply because I had seen him, as a younger kid. And when he first came here, I thought, as a freshman when he was our varsity three-pounder, I thought, he's going to be a pretty good three-pounder for us. And, figuring maybe at least as a freshman, you figure at least he'd be 500. I think he was 35-9 and 6th in the state. So, I think from that point on, once I saw him in the middle of our season his freshman year and you could see that he was special, then you could kind of start to see that he was going to be a real, real good wrestler for 4 years. But initially, you don't know until you actually see somebody on a mat against varsity competition. And, you knew he had the skills, but when you start competing against, sophomores, juniors, and seniors when you're freshmen, there was a couple kids he wrestled in the state tournament that were seniors when he was a freshman that year. So, but midway through his freshman year, I think you could start to see, that there was something special there that was going to be there for a while, and, really something to be real proud of, obviously, for our school.
What was your reaction when he broke it?
I think when anybody breaks a record, that's been there for a while, I think it's kind of a combination of relief, even on my part, thinking, okay, he's broken it, he stayed healthy enough to do it, he didn't get hurt. You have to look at records of that nature. I think in the 4 years he's been here, I do not think, and I would just about be positive, that he's never missed a match for any reason, which is part of that record. You have to have the longevity and the the endurance and the strength to do it to begin with. I think it was kind of relief to know that, hey, he's got the record, and from now on, whatever he does is You know, it's just an add to that record. Proud. I'm really proud of him. I mean, you know, he's been in a lot of tournaments. He's wrestled some really, really good kids, and he's beaten some really, really good kids. I mean, he's beaten state champs, you know, or kids that at one point in time have become a state champ or a state runner-up. So I really proud. Pride is my thing with him. I think, you know, he's done such a good job, and he's represented himself in this school so well for so many years. It's a proud moment as a coach to have, you know, someone of that caliber that represents you and your team, you know, and, you know, you go someplace and, you know, he's respected because he's been around for so long and people are know what he can do and know what his capabilities are. So I'm really proud. I think that's that was kind of beaming with pride, you know, and I will continue to be, obviously, as long as he keeps going this year. So, you know, he's wrestling real well. So I think, you know, he's going to go a long way this season, hopefully, if he just continues to wrestle well and stays healthy.
Did you do the Toyota jump when he broke the record?
I think I'll save that. I'll save that jump for someplace, hopefully in the state tournament. Hopefully I'll save a jump for something, whether it's, you know, whether it's making it to the final or whether it's placing or something. I think I'll save that. Those moments are kind of savored, though, I think. And I remember when Aaron Colley wrestled in his last match in the state tournament, and he ended up winning a match and took fifth in the state. And I think it was more emotional than anything else, because you actually look at this kid. I remember looking at the clock, and there were like 30 seconds left in the match, and I got kind of emotional because I thought, this is the last 30 seconds I'm going to have with this kid ever. You know, this is it. This is the last time he's going to walk on that mat for us. And I think that's how I'll feel with Drake. I think, you know, when the final match comes, hopefully in the state tournament someplace, you know, I hope it's a match he can win, and I hope, you know, I hope it's a place match, you know, for some place in the state. But I think I'll feel the same way. I think it'll hit me that, hey, it's over, you know. And actually, I looked at the clock in Aaron's match, and I remember exactly what the time was, and I kind of thought, I savored it, you know. I just didn't think about nothing. I just kind of savored it and watched. So that's how it'll be with him, I'm sure.
Thank you, Coach.
Yeah, you're welcome. Thanks. Appreciate it.
Wow, that was very interesting. I hope Drake has another great season. Well, for Ryan Casper and Nate Holzman, back to the desk.
Drake had an amazing season. He ended up taking sixth at state, which is a remarkable. Yeah. Senior year, ended up in a bang. Jason Lipsky also took sixth. Then Martin Ferrer got eliminated in the first round, but he had some back problems plaguing him all year.
Yes.
How did you do in wrestling?
Oh, last night I defeated Goldberg, Hulk Hogan, and Macho Man Randy Savage. But, of course, I was in my Nintendo 64.
That's all right, Lee. WWF wrestling is exciting, and it is a sport. For all you people out there who are going to criticize and
yes.
Say it's fake.
All right. Ooh. I got some advice for you. All you guys out there. You should go and get this Oak Creek Knights football video yearbook. It's a hot deal out there. For $15, you can come up down to the TV station and pick up your copy for only $15. Let me tell you, it's class act right here.
I think we're going to watch a clip from it for the Maguanago game.
Kick is up. It's long enough. Oh, it hit the crossbar and bounced back. Fake punt, fake punt. Carlos keeps it. Across the 20.
was exciting.
Yeah, very.
If you guys want to come down to the Oak Creek studio, you can pick up your copy for only $15 and see our two bright smiling faces on you.
Actually, you'll see probably Mike mostly since I didn't play that much. But
well, if you're looking for it, I'm number 5. I'm usually the guy with the ball.
Yeah. I'm number 2, so check me out too.
Quit whining, says the legendary gym teacher and bodybuilder Manko. Here's Lee here, my partner in crime, with an interview.
Do the Gene Simmons, do the Gene Simmons.
There's a man behind all this sweat and hard work, Mr. Dick Manko. Join me, Leo Dea, in our KnightZone conversation to get a closer look on Mr. Mankowski.
Hi, I'm here with Mr. Mankowski, the head of the gym department here at Oak Creek High School. I'm going to sit down for a little interview and ask him a few questions. How are you doing, Mr. Mankowski?
Very good.
I understand you used to coach a little back in the days. How was that and how come you stopped?
Back in the days. Yeah, I started here in 1968. I coached football and wrestling until probably about 86, 87. Stopped. As my kids started growing up and I started missing their playing football, wrestling, and gave up coaching so I could watch them.
All right, so did you enjoy coaching?
Oh, yeah. I did it over 20 some years.
All right. I understand you stay after school every day in the weight room to supervise the kids while they lift.
Yep. Used to run it from 3 to 5. I started running the weight room here about 1972. They put the expansion on it in about 1988. And I've been running it for all those years.
I understood you also play a little college football. Can you explain a little of that?
I was lucky enough to get full scholarship at University of Colorado back in the days when we had the Hamlets, you know. About played there from 1960 to 1965.
Okay. What are some of your favorite things about teaching gym class and running the weight room?
Well, I get paid to do things I like. I get paid to lift weights, paid to exercise, and I enjoy having, you know, working with the kids.
I seem to see around in the weight room you wearing shirts that say the emblem "Quit Whining" on that. Can you explain that a little bit?
I think Mr. Trendle started that many years ago. He was at some tavern in Madison that had a "Quit Whining" logo on it. I mean, it just kind of adopted it in the fire department. So every time we started exercise, the kids would start, "I don't want to do that." So we started wearing shirts that said "Quit Whining." It just became the motto.
So you see a lot of whining around here?
All the time.
So out of all things, whether it be teaching gym, running the weight room, what's your favorite thing about teaching here at Oak Creek High School?
My favorite? I got probably one more year left and I retire. No, I have had a good time. I've been here 31 years. I just enjoy it. I enjoy the lifting. I learn coming to kids and playing with them. I enjoy the coaching. Sorry, sometimes I gave it up.
All right. Thanks a lot, Mr. Minkowski.
Man, that Manko is a class act and a swell guy.
He's a character. And what a great guy he is. Always working for the kids, staying after, helping us weightlift, teaching us the correct things to do.
Yeah, tough guy too, very tough.
The toughest I've ever seen.
All right. With the end of the girls' basketball season quickly approaching, here's a girls' basketball video highlight. That was definitely a intense game of video highlights. What do you think the final score of that game was?
I was at the game. I believe it was 6-4.
Oh, yeah. Very high scoring.
Yeah, one of the most high scoring games of the year for girls basketball.
Yeah, I agree. I do agree that this is a great moment for girls basketball, but I do not see the great big deal in them making to this sectional playoff. What do you think?
I mean, they're good. Everyone's admitting that. They're going up against one of the best teams in the state. They're ranked 5th, I believe, but football did it.
I mean, what, did we go to state 1-2 years, or what? I mean,
this concludes this edition of Night Zone. Thanks for the love, Oak Creek. Everyone loves girls basketball, not football. Yeah. That's right.
Nothing to do with your school.
Party people! Goes a little something like this. Tag team, back again. Check it to wreck it, let's begin. Party on, party people, let me hear some noise. DC's in the house, jump, jump, rejoices. There's a party over here, a party over there. Wave your hands in the air, shake the dairy, yeah. These three words mean you're getting busy. Whoop, that is Hitman. All you folks what it's all about. Now it's time for to get on the mic and make this motherfucking party hype. I'm taking it back to the old school, cause I'm an old fool who's so cool. If you wanna get down, I'ma show you the way. Boom, there it is, let me hear you say.
Hi, and welcome to Upon Further Review. I'm your host, Eric Weiss.
And I'm your other host, Brianne Tobin.
Upon Further Review is a show where, well, we review things. Everything from movies to Music, video games, stores, and even food.
Snacks.
Or snacks, either way.
How do you feel about the show, Eric?
I feel good. Feel good.
Are
and you
excited?
A little bit.
I'm excited about the new show.
I think things are going to, you know, go well with this show. We hope so, at least.
I have a positive attitude about it, too.
Office Space recently came out in theaters. Joanne Strong had a chance to review it.
I'm here on location at South Shore Cinemas to review The Office Space.
Office Space was created by Mike Judge, who also created Beavis and Butthead, and more recently, King of the Hill.
And co-creator of King of the Hill comes a movie about
Ron Livingston stars as computer tech who gets fed up with his job and his life. He goes to a hypnotist who hypnotizes him, but dies before he can snap his fingers to relieve Livingston of his hypnosis. He just doesn't care about anything or anybody at his job and thinks about getting fired.
We need to talk about your flair.
Jennifer Aniston plays Livingston's love interest, who thinks that he is only crazy for wanting to quit.
37 pieces of flair on today. And a terrific smile.
Instead of getting fired, he thinks that he can just get promoted. He just gets promoted while his friends get laid off. He uses his power and plants a virus into the company's computer, and he convinces two of his friends to play along. But some things trip them up along the way.
Well, it looks like you've been missing quite a bit of work lately.
Well, I wouldn't say I've been missing it, Bob. That's just a straight shooter with upper management written all over him.
We're going to be getting rid of these people here, Mr. Samir. Okay.
Night eating in a jet. Night eating in a jet.
Not going to work here anymore anyway.
You haven't been showing up and you get to keep your job.
Actually, I'm being promoted.
Thank you, Bob.
This is a suck.
They're going to throw you out on the street
so that Bill Lumberg's stock will go up.
It's completely unfair.
Initech deserves to go down.
We're just the guys to do it.
Tell me about that virus you're always talking about.
One that could rip off the company for a bunch of money.
I'm not going to do anything illegal.
Illegal? Samir, this is America.
The worst they're going to do is they put you in a white-collar minimum security resort for a couple of months. You know they have conjugal visits there?
I might be showing them my old face.
Oh.
They let you have sex with women?
They sure do.
Okay, I'll do it.
Your job sucked. Well, I loved Office Space, so I highly recommend it. It's in theaters everywhere. I'm Joanne Strong. Now back to the desk.
Did you get to see that movie Office Space?
Yeah, actually, I did. It's really good. You should go see it. Even that $8 or whatever you have to pay to see a movie, it's worth it. Trust me. You should really go see it.
I haven't gotten the chance to see it yet. It looks really funny, though.
Take the time. Really. It's worth it.
I will. When the word cool is used, Target is usually not far behind. Here's Kyle with more.
Oh my God, I need some new boxers. These are all dirty. And look at these clothes, they're nothing but rags. And I'm so hungry, I wish I had some food. You don't have any food. And look at these Nintendo games. They're so 1987. But I don't have any money. Where can I get all this for 56 cents?
Easter fastly approaching. With Easter fastly approaching, Target has a wide selection of candy for your youngster. Target also has a variety of groceries which are essential for everyday living. Need school supplies? Don't worry. Target has a wide selection of crayons, notebooks, and yes, even trapper keepers. Are you sick? Target will cure what ails you with a large selection of medicine. TVs, video games, CDs, radios, Target is full of electronic devices for your personal use. Planning on early Christmas shopping or want to buy your child a present? Target has all the latest toys to keep your children occupied. Charlie Murphy is cooking Johnsonville brats, and Cindy wants some too. You like sports? So does Target. Sick of paying an arm and a leg for clothes? Target has all the major brands for low, low prices. Expecting a baby? Come to Target. Everyone loves jewelry, and so does Target. Upon further review, my trip to Target was a most excellent adventure. Target, my store, your store, our store.
We would also like to thank the manager, Cindy, from Target for letting us go inside the store and making that story. I've gotten to know Cindy over the years. I'm in Target at least every week.
Really? Really? Nice lady?
Yeah, she's a very nice lady. I love Target. That's my favorite store.
Shop anywhere else?
No, just Target.
All right then. Well, we have Brandon and Evan here with their movie review of Pulp Fiction. Let's take a look.
Hi, welcome to our movie review. I'm Brandon and this is Evan. This week we reviewed the movie Pulp Fiction, and I thought it was a pretty good movie. How about you?
I really liked it.
Yeah, it had a lot of action, a lot of dark humor, which I prefer. I like that. There's bloody parts. I like that too. Fast food scenes. It was a good movie. I'd probably, out of 4 stars, how many would you give it?
4 stars.
Yeah, I'd probably give it 4. Quentin Tarantino is probably one of my favorite directors. Take a look. You liked what you saw, then you probably want to go pick that one up. We liked it. It's probably at some video store. Well, that wraps it up for this edition of the Brandon and Evan Review. Well, I'll see you next week unless we get fired or something. See you later.
Eric, have you ever seen Pulp Fiction?
Yeah, actually, I did. I think I was in elementary school at the time.
Yeah, it did bring back old memories.
Yeah, old is right. But it's a good movie. If you get a chance, you should probably go rent it, you know, if you can find it anywhere.
Yeah. Shopping for food can be a tedious task, especially when, especially crunchy snacks. Here's Steve with some smacking help.
Steve Gillespie here at the local supermarket. And I personally love the supermarket. I think it's a lot of fun shopping, and I think the best part of shopping, in my opinion, is the snacks. Well, all right, the second best part of shopping. Well, there is a lot of snacks out there, so I'll help you choose between the two of them. I'll find two great contenders and I'll pit them against each other, making this the Snacktacular Challenge. I'll find two good snacks and I'll tell you which one's better.
So come on, feel the noise. Girls, rock your boys. We'll get
now, before you go shopping for snacks, I'll give you a few tips on shopping in general. Now, snacks is the most fun part of shopping, so I suggest buying all your necessities first. And I think you should be very thorough and get plenty of the products you need. And you really can't live without such as shades. Shades are good. I also recommend Pink Lady Razors. Those are good also. And contrary to many people's beliefs, you cannot buy enough toilet paper. And you should buy between $75 and $80 worth of toilet paper every time you go shopping. And it is impossible to have enough of it. There I am, with some toilet paper. Also, you should pick up some info. It's free, and, you know, pick up as much as you want. It's very helpful, I feel. But after you get done with all your necessities, now is the fun part. You get the snacks. And a lot of people eat snacks such as fruits and vegetables. or other healthy snacks such as fish sticks and ham, but I don't recommend these at all, and I think you should look for fatty snacks with a lot of crunch. And these snacks are located all throughout the stores, but I'll try to find some good ones for you. Here we go.
Great snacks out there. Today I think I'll just go to the old rutabaga barrel and see what that has in store for me. It usually picks pretty good snacks, you know? Let's see what we got. Ooh, we got a fairly new product on the market, 3Ds by Doritos. They're a combination of the regular Doritos and a three-dimensional shape. They look quite tasty. Let's see what else we got in here. The contender. We got, Old Dutch original tostados, a great favorite, enjoyed for many generations, I believe. They're lightly salted, as you can see, and they look light and flaky, and they also look quite delicious. Let's see which one wins as they stack up to each other. By Doritos, and they, on the crunchability factor, they were pretty crunchy, but not as crunchy as the regular Doritos. The impression I got out of these was, you know, a misguided bugle, if you will. Bugle being the veteran of the crispy corn snack on the market. But 3D Doritos, they aren't bad, but they lack that little something that Bugles or regular Doritos has, which is crunchability. Point in the tostados column for also crunchability and dipability. Because they're quite crunchy as I tried them, and you can also dip them in a variety of sauces, if you will, such as salsa, cheese, salsa con queso, guacamole, whatever. They're durable and they're quite versatile. Or for 3D's Doritos versus Old Dutch original tostados, I'm going to have to go with tostados as the better buy. Because as you can see, a price tag of only $1.99. For the tostados, they give you more crunchability, dipability, and durability as compared to the 3Ds with carrying a price tag of $3.19. And they just don't cut it as far as a crunchy snack to fuel your midnight cravings. So if you're in the market for a good snack, I recommend Old Dutch original tostados. They get the Steve Gillespie official approval rating of snacktastic. Steve Gillespie saying farewell from snack heaven, and always remember, just keep on snacking.
Ask you a question, you answer, don't ask me, please. So, if you had to choose between the two chips, which one would you pick?
I never tried the Doritos 3Ds yet. No? It sounds a little catchy. I think I'd probably try the Tostitos or Tostados.
Sounds good.
Yeah.
Any big plans for the weekend?
No, I don't. I think I have to work. No. What are you doing this weekend?
I don't know. I was thinking about seeing a movie, but I just don't know which one.
Well, I think we're going to wrap it up now. For Upon Further Review, this is Brianne Tobin and Eric Weiss.
It's a little secret, just the Robinson's affair. Most of all, we've got to hide it from the kids. Cuckoo, ca-choo, Mrs. Robinson. Jesus loves you more than you will know. Whoa, whoa, whoa. God bless you, please, Mrs. Robinson. Heaven holds a place for those who pray. You